Anything that will give salvation is for everybody. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes, whosoever, I mean all who believe in Jesus, they will be saved. When I go to heaven, you ask John, you ask Paul, you ask Job, you ask Daniel, you ask Moses, how are you saved? They will say, we are saved by grace, not the law. My brothers and sisters, we need to be told the truth. The law was given to Israel by God, written by God, placed in the air, stands forever. The law is important. Some say, Colossians 2, 16, they said because of that text, it's an indication that the law is no more in existence. Let me read that. Colossians 2, verse 16. I'll quote the books of the various churches and what their leaders say about the text. If it is talking about the law of God or the ceremonial law. Colossians 2, 16. Let no man therefore judge you in what you eat or you drink or in respect of a holy day or the new moon or on the Sabbath day. They used it to say that. So don't judge me. Don't judge me. The Bible says don't judge me. They refer that this text talks about nothing but the Ten Commandments. It's not true. If you read verse 17, it says these are shadows of things to come. So you look at it, the moral law is never to be downplayed upon. The Ten Commandments is holy. The Ten Commandments is special. The Ten Commandments is very unique. My brothers and sisters, Jesus, when he was dying, he cried out with a loud voice and yielded up his spirit. And behold, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. And the earth shook and the rocks were split. Jesus said, it is finished. Then the temple opened, the veil. You ask major leaders, someone like Adam Clark, he said, Colossians 2, 14 and 16, by handwriting of ordinances, the apostle most evidently means the ceremonial law. You ask one of the charismatic leaders or the Protestant leaders, he says, J. Hyatt also confirms that Jesus did not give a new code, but he also did not say that the moral law teaching of the Old Testament was suspended. The ceremonial law and the ritual law of the OT, they were abrogated for Christians, but not the Ten Commandments. John Wesley appears to be even more emphatic and very specific. He says the ritual or the ceremonial law delivered by Moses to the children of Israel, containing all the injunction and ordinances which relate to the old sacrifices and services of the temple. Our Lord indeed did not come to destroy, but the moral law contained in the Ten Commandments and enforced by the prophet, he did not take away. The leaders of the various major churches who formed Protestantism, Presby, Anglican, Methodists, all these leaders say the Ten Commandments is still in place today. Why are people jeopardizing God's law? What was nailed to the cross was the ceremonial law. I wish I had time to explain in detail, but I don't have all the time. My brothers and sisters, tonight it must be made plain and clear. The Siamese twins in the Bible, law, grace. Law and grace. Indeed, God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He doesn't change. Grace always leads us to obedience. Guess what? When I was coming from a youth program recently, our university congress, called the NAS Congress. I was beginning an evangelistic series in one of Ghana's major municipal. It's called Aplau Water. I left 4 a.m. and I was to preach 6 p.m. Come on, buddy. 140 kilometer per hour. 150 kilometer per hour. Zigzim. When I enter the portals, the car will make zigzim, 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 zigzim. Come on. My wife could not help me, so she slept. She closed her eyes till she sleep. I got to a place, then the police officer said, stop. He said, back. So they said, license. I said, quiet. I pulled up my license. I was so angry. I said, if they dare me, I will pour fire on them. Let me check my license. It has expired. I became quiet. So when I went there, they said, license. Then I pulled my pastoral license. He said, hey, oga, 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 oga. I said, driving license. So I said, take your time. Are we fighting? Lord, have mercy. So I gave him my driving license. Honestly speaking, I never know it as a spy. So all my ego were all down. So he said, you're under arrest. I said, sure. He said, I'll process you to court. I said, sure. Then he wanted to, then I said, excuse me. I said, do you know who I am? I said, he said, I don't care. I said, I'm also a law police, but my police is in church. I teach in the church that they must keep the law.